should be just at the right depth. I'm sticking a lot to in either side of it in the set field. And I'm just pressing it in there, poking it down, and that's it. And that's quite a thing.
It's quite jammed in.
On the inside. These CZs are quite well cut and they're quite thick girdles, like most modern CZs, so they can take a bit of poking about here. They're not really, unless you abuse these stones, they shouldn't chip or crack or anything during this procedure. Just tweaking that in a little bit. A wee bit of weight on it, not too much. And that's that one in.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not set yet, obviously, we need to get these little beads over, but they're in stuck in place. If we had, if we had the whole, got a whole ring to do, I generally do stones like this in groups of five, so I'd put in five stones and then set five and then move on to the next five. But if you're really in a hurry and stuff like that, you could try and jam in hole everything you could see, because they are stuck in the hole, and that's pretty, speeds the whole thing up, I imagine. Rattling out the stones without any difficulty. Put one more in.
When you're setting stones partly like that, do they have to be in a straight line, or can you have them curving and things?
Absolutely curving, yeah. Not very much. It's not really, if there's a rule, you probably want the same, if this is a parameter, the same cutter in there, the same width, percentage it is. And the beads, you probably want them placed in a very similar manner. If they're on a curve, there's a kind of difference in the size of the outer circumference and the inner circumference. And that does affect the spacing of the beads marginally. Generally speaking, if there's an outside curve, I would make that bead a little bit bigger than the inside bead by maybe a tenth, like a tenth of a mil, just to fill up the space, because there is more space there. But it's other than that, it's a bit better. If it's a tight corner, you might double up the claws. If it was a really tight curve, we might have two beads on the outside and one bead on the inside.
Yeah, because it's bigger.
To avoid you having big holes in between things before you do them in a big space. Yeah, we've had loads out there, as always, we'll just lift that slightly. Yeah. Gentle but firm pressure, and the tweezers should suffice. We shouldn't be banging about here with anything else. Note that I'm not even in here with a burr of any kind, but could be if the need arose. So if you find you've got one hole smaller than the others or whatever, we could go in with a burr and just burr these out very slightly. Maybe a heart burr possibly, or just a little ball burr, just to shade out a little bit. What would be a tragedy is if you've got 20 stones to do and you've got everything's slightly too small and you've got to borrow every hole, that's a missed opportunity, but it doesn't necessarily become apparent that that's the case until you're sitting down with the casting and you think, oh god, which one you've already got it casting, quite old, you really are not going to go back and start with. But assuming your stones are accurate, if you follow the 3% rule, this should be the outcome of it.
Was it 2.5 stones?
It's 2.25. 2.25, and that's the size I put in the nature class, but not, it didn't even put 2.3 or 2.2, it's 2.25.
2.25, so
it's really that precise and that kind of precision as possible. Pressing down in there, this is a big hole bigger against itself, obviously. Squish it straight down. Okay, so I've got three stones stuck in place. And it's a little bit like flush setting type territory where they're stuck in a taper. Which we've been through already. You know, a beautiful thing when you get the stone stuck in the hole, then you know, it's already halfway there. And these are halfway there, I think. Just take it, pass it around.